Hello and welcome to Azure Resources and Resource Groups. Before you can deploy resources in Microsoft Azure, you need to first create at least one resource group. With that in mind, let's define these two terms. A resource is an item. It's a manageable item that's available through Azure. You can think of virtual machines, storage accounts, web apps, databases, virtual networks. All these things are examples of resources. Essentially, anything that you can deploy within Microsoft Azure is a resource. A resource group, on the other hand, is a container. It's a container that holds all of your related resources for a specific Azure solution. Resource groups, or a resource group, I should say, typically includes the resources that you want to manage as a group. You decide which resources belong in a resource group based on what makes the most sense for your organization. You can look at Azure resource groups as essentially the fundamental element of the Azure platform. As I mentioned, it's a container that you deploy Azure resources to. Now, I should point out that all resources must belong to a resource group, and a single resource can only be a member of one resource group. So you can't have a resource being a member of two different resource groups. Now, on the flip side of that, there are many resources in Azure that you can move between resource group with some services having some specific limitations or requirements to move them. I should also mention that resource groups can't be nested. Ultimately, resource groups are available and used to help you organize Azure resources. This means that if you place resources of similar usage or type or location within a single resource group, you can provide a little bit of order or organization to those resources that you deploy in Azure. Generally speaking, when you deploy resources into a single resource group, that resource group should, in best practice, include resources that have a similar life cycle. So for example, if you deploy everything into a resource, let's say a virtual machine, a virtual network, some disks, you know, maybe a SQL server. If you deploy these into a resource group, once you delete that resource group, all of those resources that were deployed into that resource group are going to be deleted. That's why organizing these resources by lifecycle can be useful in both production and non-production environments. More specifically, non-production environments, because you may, in non-production environments or like lab environments, what you'll typically do is experiment and then build out a lab and then dispose of it. By building your development environments and segmenting them into resource groups, those resource groups make it easy to remove all of those development resources all at once when you're done with them. Now, I should also point out that resource groups are also used as a scope for applying role-based access control. In other words, by applying the RBAC permissions to a specific resource group, that simplifies the administration and makes it easier to limit access to only those who need access to the resources within that resource group. So for example, if you have SQL servers and you only want your SQL admins to have access to those, maybe you put them all in a SQL server resource group and then apply RBAC permissions to that particular resource group for only your SQL admins. And then the same thing for VM admins, maybe some virtual network admins, etc. So you can not only break your resource groups up by lifecycle, but you can also break them up by function if that helps you better limit who needs access to what. So what you really need to remember when sitting the exam is that a resource is a manageable item available through Azure. Think virtual machines, storage accounts, web apps, databases, virtual networks, SQL servers, all of these pieces that you deploy through that portal, they're resources. And those resources are contained in resource groups. Resource groups include those resources that you want to manage as a group. You get to decide which resources belong in a resource group based on what makes the most sense for what you're trying to accomplish. And you can use resource groups to group things by function, by life cycle, or really by any idea that makes the most sense for your organization.